Welcome back to my channel. I hope you are all doing great today. Today's tutorial is on figure variations and body measurements. I am going to discuss the different figure variations and how important it is for taking accurate body measurements of your client or for personal use. Before you begin the process of measuring a client, it is important to assess the unique characteristics of the body being measured to avoid fitting problems. In her book, Pattern Making for Fashion Design, Helen Joseph Armstrong illustrated different figure variations, such as head height, back, hip, arm, shoulder, legs, figure stance, and their relationship with one another. Let's take a closer look at some of these figure variations. The first figure variation is the head height. It is measured as the length of your head from the top of the crown to the chin level. Here in this picture, three sample models are set against a perfect model dressed in red. The head measurement is used to mark each head length down from the chin. Meanwhile, the red lines behind the sample models indicate the head levels. The broken lines crossing the sample models indicate where the bust point, hip, crotch, and knee are in relation to the standard head marks of the perfect model in red. You can see the variations in measurement for each model. Next figure variation is the back. There are four basic back types. The first model has an ideal back. The spine, in this case, has a soft curve and slight protruding buttock. The second model has a flat back, characterized by straight back, which causes buttocks to be prominent. The third model has a rounded back. In this case, a dominant spine curve and prominent buttocks. The last model, the fourth model, has a Dowager's hump in which the shoulders fall forward in the extreme. Next figure variation is the hip. There are four hip types. The ideal hip, heart shape, square shape, and diamond shape. Next up is the arm type. The first model has an ideal arm. The flesh and bone are in perfect harmony. The second model has a thin arm with bony appearance, prominent wrist, elbow, and shoulder bones. The third model has full arms with flesh starting to fall from top of the arm. The fourth and last model has fleshy arm with bone structure covered with flesh. Flesh has fallen from top of the arm. Next figure variation is the shoulder type. The first model has ideal shoulders. The second model has sloped shoulders. The third model has square shoulders. The fourth model has muscular shoulders. The fifth model has bony shoulders with dominant clavicle. Next up is the leg type. The first model has bow legs, while the second model has knock knees. It's also possible that your client may have thin thighs or full thighs. These leg types are very important in drafting patterns of skirts, shorts, trousers, or jumpsuits. Other figure variations that are very essential for body measurements are the back bust or chest relationship. The first model in the picture is ideal. The bust and buttocks protrude in a harmonious relationship. The second model has a narrow back and large bust. The third model has a full back and small bust. The fourth model has a hollow inward chest, while the fifth model has a pigeon or dominant chest bone. The next figure variation is the shoulder, waist, and hip relationship. The first model in the picture is ideal. The shoulder, waist, and hip are in harmony. The second model has an hourglass shape, which is created by a small waist. The third model has a straight line with slightly defined waist. The fourth model has wide shoulder and narrow waist, while the fifth model has narrow shoulder and wide hips. Next up is the abdominal and thigh relationship. The first model in the picture shows the abdomen in relationship with the thigh, has an I shape. The second model has R shape. The third model has S shape. The fourth model has an oval O shape. Finally, the fifth model has an O shape. The last figure variation is the figure stance. The first model has a perfect posture. The second model has a bent posture, while the last model has an upright posture. The outcome of your measurement and hence the final fitting of garments depends on a large extent on the figure variations of the body being measured. I hope you have learned a lot from watching this video. What body type are you? You can drop your comments or questions at the comment section below. Kindly subscribe to my channel by clicking on the red subscribe button and also on the notification bell next to it, so that whenever I upload new videos, you'll be notified. Thanks for watching. Bye.